When I want to find out what's going on with the Giants, I take to Twitter and I follow Ralph Vacchiano from the New York Daily News because he's on top of all of it, and we've got him here right now. Ralph, how you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Okay, the Eli Manning book is doing well?
It is. It's been out there for a while, and so many people are still buying it, so I'm always happy to hear that.
And hopefully it does as well as Eli's been doing since you wrote it. Great game last week, NFC Offensive Player of the Week coming back against the 49ers. Now it's the Eagles, and they got wiped out down here at Lincoln Financial Field last year. Victor Cruz with the injury. It'd be so nice if you were able to make a comeback this Monday night. But what are you seeing when you look at this game?
Well, to be perfectly honest, more than any game on the Giants' schedule, I don't know what I see looking at this game because I've been watching the Eagles from afar like everybody else in the NFL and around the NFL, and I don't understand what Chip Kelly has done down there. I don't know what to make of it. I just tell people he's one of two things. He's either an idiot or a genius, and I don't know that we've figured that out yet. So know how the Giants are going to attack them or what or how they're going to do is hard for me to tell. But for the Giants, I can tell you this, it's a hugely important game for them because they have worked really hard to get back from their 0-2 start. They're 3-2 now. They were 3-2 last year, same situation, 0-2, 3-2. They got 3-2, went down to Philadelphia, and that bad loss set them on a 7-game losing streak that destroyed their season. I think for them, this is a huge emotional and mental hurdle for them to get over. If they lose and start a little slide again, I don't know that they'll be able to recover, but if they win, I mean, they might be the team to beat in the NFC East all of a sudden.
I think that I agree with that, but I think that the Philadelphia game always means so much more. Maybe it just seems to mean so much more to me as a Giant fan watching it. But how does it, you know, how does it play to the, you know, to the team themselves? Because it always seems to be the Philadelphia game where all kinds of weird things happen.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. I go back and forth on who the Giants' biggest rival is, whether it's Dallas or the Eagles, and I think sometimes it just depends on which team is doing better at the time. But, there's no such thing as an uninteresting game against the Eagles. It does mean something to them. They're close by rivals. They follow them. They hear about them. And like you said, every game seems to have, there are very few boring ones. So whether it's a big injury, a huge play, there's often a lot of points. Certainly, if Chip Kelly's offense is going to be what everybody thinks it's going to be, there'll be a lot of points in this game because the Giants don't play much defense. I think it's going to be a great one for the nation to watch on Monday Night Football. I can see why they made that the game because there will be a lot of intrigue and probably a lot of scoring.
Are you surprised it's not the Sunday night game, that they gave this to Monday night instead?
No, not really. I don't know how they figure that out, but I would assume that when I almost forgot who's televising the game. When ESPN picks their Monday night games, my guess is they not only look at the fact that these games are interesting, but two pretty huge markets as well.
Now, the difference this year is, I think, the way the Steve Spagnuolo defense will handle the Chip Kelly offense as opposed to the way the Perry Fuel defense handled it the last three times. What do you see when you look at that, especially with the fact that the Giants don't seem to have a pass rush going on?
No, they have zero pass rush at the moment. Although, I will say this, they did move Colin Kaepernick out of the pocket last Sunday night pretty well, and they got after him.
Did they do that, or did he do that?
Well, I think in some cases they did move him. Maybe it was a design play, and I don't know it, but it looked like there were times his pocket collapsed, and then he took off. So I guess my point is that they can generate a little bit of a rush. Finishing it is a whole other story. They don't have a lot of sacks this season. They don't have that one monster guy, especially with Jason Pierre-Paul hurt. They didn't have that last year either, but the difference last year was they were not an aggressive defense. They played a kind of a passive scheme. It wasn't really read and react, but that's kind of the way the players described it. They just waited for plays to come to them.
Right.
Steve Spagnuolo is of the late Jim Johnson school of defense: attack, be aggressive, dictate where the defense goes and where the offense goes. And that's what they're doing now. It's why they've been able to create turnovers because they're not afraid to. They don't have to sit back and just wait and say we got to kind of cover up our weaknesses and holes. They're going after it. If they get beat, they get beat, but they will also create some turnovers in their favor.
And the Eagle D offense is predicated on the run. They have to be able to run the ball. The Giants lead the league in stopping the run, or they did up until the last game. And Kerry Wynn has made a big difference for them at defensive end as well. How do you see that playing out, knowing that, you know, the Eagles run the ball the way they do? They've also had trouble running up the middle because of the offensive line problems.
Well, you know, for the Giants, running up the middle on them is going to be nearly impossible. Jonathan Hankins, their big defensive tackle, doesn't get a lot of credit for what he does. I think he's probably a Pro Bowl caliber defensive tackle, especially if he could ever add a few sacks to his resume. You know, they get enough out of the second defensive tackle spot, but the run defense is really sparked by Hankins and linebacker John Beeson, who's healthy. When he's healthy, he is a very good linebacker, maybe not, you know, one of the top 10 in the league, but certainly in the next tier, and especially when it comes to stopping the run. So they have players there who really can get the job done. And as you mentioned, Kerry Wynn, you know, guys like him, Robert Ayers, if he plays, they're not great pass rushers, but they are guys who really play fundamentally sound, contain the edges, and you don't see a lot of running lanes that opposing running backs have.
They've had a lot of injuries. Is Devon Kennard going to play this week? Is Beeson going to be able to play? And Une Unga does a good job filling in, but he still makes rookie mistakes. How do you see it shaking out? Do you know anything about the injuries of who's going to play so far?
Yeah, we don't know for sure yet, but we just know that there are a lot of injuries. Odell Beckham, Victor Cruz, Ruben Randall, all of them have somewhat murky statuses for Monday night. That's the entire offense right there. You mentioned John Beeson, obviously, and Robert Ayers, George Selvey, two of their two starting defensive ends, all have some kind of murky, iffy status for Monday night. That's really been the Giants' problem, and they've been the most injured team in the NFL over the previous two seasons. They seem to be going that way this year. You got to also remember that Jason Pierre-Paul is still out as well. They for whatever reason cannot stay healthy, and that's what's keeping them from being a good team. And when I made my prediction at the beginning of the season, I said the same thing, that they could be 10-6, they could be 6-10. It's going to depend on who's out there on the field, and if all those guys we mentioned are missing, they're going to have a hard time beating anybody.
Talking to Ralph Vacchiano of the New York Daily News, you can follow him at Ralph Vacchiano. Getting into the Giant offense, we hear so much about the Eagle offense and Chip Kelly's revolutionizing football with this offense. Ben McAdoo came in for the Giants, and Eli looks better in this offense, I think, than I've ever seen him look in the old Gilbride offense, and he won two Super Bowls in that one. What do you think about Eli and the Giant offense and what you've seen the last 2 years?
Well, what I've seen is he's becoming a much more efficient quarterback, and I do think some of that is that he's playing better. Some of it definitely is the scheme that Ben McAdoo runs, which, with all due respect to Kevin Gilbride, who I thought was a terrific offensive coordinator, obviously the Giants won two Super Bowls with him. You know, his offense was predicated on big plays and throwing downfield. The McAdoo offense is the more typical short, quick passing offense, which moves the ball little bits at a time and sets up the big play. And, you know, when you have those short, quick passes, you're basically saying, I've got good playmakers for my targets, so I'm going to put the ball in their hands and let them try to do something. And Eli is suited for that because he is one of the smartest quarterbacks in the league. You know, he does not make, although he has made a couple this season, he does not usually make mental mistakes on which receiver to go to. He's very good at, you know, determining which one is going to be open on a certain play. And if you need a smart quarterback to run that kind of offense, who can make decisions sometimes in under 2 seconds. I think against the Bills and their crazy pass rush a couple of weeks ago, he averaged 1.7 seconds when he threw the ball, and his completion percentage was pretty high as well. So McAdoo's definitely turned him into an efficient quarterback, and you know, once he gets all his weapons on the field, you know, those are guys that can take a 5-yard pass and turn it into a 90-yard pass. So you know, that's why this offense is so dangerous.
And one of the X factors, Shane Vereen, new this year and basically carried that final drive against the 49ers, along with Eli.
Yeah, no question. You know, we look back over the past decade or so that Eli Manning's been the quarterback. He really only had one running back that he could trust out of the backfield, and that was Tiki Barber, who's been gone since 2006. You know, even Kevin Gilbride wanted this in his offense. They needed that running back to be that safety valve who could, you know, be out in the middle of the field, who could run a screen and make something of it. And I think they have that in Vereen. When they signed him away from the Patriots, they touted him not as a running back, but as a weapon. And they even made a point of saying, look, we could line him up as a wide receiver if we wanted to, because he has that kind of speed to get down the field. And you know, I think you're starting to see that there. As they get a little bit more comfortable with this offense, as he learns it a little bit more, you're starting to see that they're finally kind of devising ways to use Vereen. And you know, a lot of the good teams have that running back who can do that, and the Giants finally have one too.
And Victor Cruz is out. He's probably not going to come back, right, for the next couple of weeks at least. And he was supposed to come back at the beginning of the season. There's always a couple of guys in the Giants that, you know, and they're going to be back next week, and then they basically never come back for, like, months. Right? Doesn't always work out that way. But
it does seem that for this team. I don't know what it is, but, yeah, it happens a lot.
Dwayne Harris, though, came out of nowhere. I know they had tried out Wes Welker, and they liked him, but they didn't sign him. And then Dwayne Harris steps up against Buffalo, has a good game against the Bills. Dependable, head down, you know, nothing gets in my way kind of receiver, and he's going to be playing the slot. What do you think about Harris and the guys that would be filling in? I got to figure Beckham's they're going to prop him up and get him out there somehow. But the guys that are filling in, if, say, Randall and Beckham don't play.
Yeah, I do think Beckham's going to play. I'm not so sure about Randall. And although Cruz wants to play, I would tend to doubt that he's going to be able. And if he somehow does get on the field, it's, you know, it wouldn't be for very long. He hasn't even practiced since, I think, August 17th. Dwayne Harris is an interesting guy. The Giants spent a lot of money on him. And, you know, it wasn't, let's call it a controversial signing, but it wasn't, you know, it didn't, like, spark back pages up here. But among the Giant fans, they were wondering, why are you spending $17 million on this guy? And the Giants, you know, touted him for his special teams ability, for his return ability, and they kept saying, you know, we're going to use him as a receiver, too. Until last week, though, they really didn't, which was a big mystery. They, you know, he wasn't doing much in the return game, and they weren't using him as a receiver. Finally, they got him in there, got him some action, and he looked like a guy who could play a little bit. And, yeah, he'll be in the slot. They really mix it. You'll see Odell Beckham sometimes in the slot, too. They kind of mix it up a little bit. But Dwayne Harris will either start for Reuben Randall or be that third receiver. And, you know, I think he's got potential to be a weapon. He definitely has speed. He's just got to get the ball in his hands more often.
Okay, so after all we've discussed, how do you see it shaking out? If you had to pick a score, Ralph Vacchiano of the New York Daily News, where would you go?
Well, the score is easy. I think this game will be in the 30s and probably come down to the wire. You know, my standard pick of Giants-Eagles is usually around 33-30. Who's going to win is a little bit more difficult. I think I'm going to go with the Giants, but I'm going to throw the caveat in of it's going to depend on who plays. You know, if Beckham, Cruz, and Randall are out, I don't know where they're going to generate their offense, and I would reserve the right to change my pick. But if they have that ability, they have Beckham. If Randall somehow gets out there and they're not too decimated by other injuries, you know, I think right now they're the better team, and they are determined, as determined as I've seen them since I started covering them, to not lose this game because they don't want to send this on another slide. They went through that last year. It was a miserable experience, and you know, I think to them, this game is just a hugely, hugely important one.
Ralph, thanks so much for coming on. Ralph Vacchiano, New York Daily News.
Hey, my pleasure. Anytime.